Good afternoon to all doctors. I welcome everyone on behalf of Predictive Study Group Hyderabad. The light has gone out, I said, yet I was wrong. The light shone in this country and worldwide was no ordinary light. The light that has illuminated for these many years will still illumine for many more years and another 1,000 years yet to come. I welcome Dr. R.V. Gayatri Devi ma'am to take over the session. Please, we understand that everyone is saddened.
Good afternoon to all doctors. Om Vijayakaraya Namaha. Every class which I take, I start with this prayer, saying Om Vijayakaraya Namaha. It's not that only I am dedicated to him. When I see across the messages, there are so many who love him. He was really enlightened. And as the doctor said, we need to take the courage and go forward and spread the light which he has shown us to practice the right homeopathy. Doctors, it is always said, when I lost my father, I was really in crossroads. I was weeping with Jacob, sir. I have lost. Sir has said one thing. Don't forget, the world is ruled by masses. You see what your father's aim is and what he has asked you to do. Do all your duties perfectly. With the same word of that, I take the courage to go forward as sir has told me. I know it is very painful. I was in fact in shock. The words fail to me. You all know Vijayakar sir is a great personality. I am happy to see you have joined here and you are supporting me to take the session forward. Doctors, before I invite someone, I would just like to speak few words about my guru, myself, who has taught me to practice the right homeopathy. I was a good practitioner, but after learning from my teacher, Dr. Praful Vijayakar sir, I have a full satisfaction in my practice. Friends, Dr. Praful Vijayakar sir, born to Dr. Gajanan Vijayakar sir, who is also a doctor, on 4th August 1952. The qualification of Vijayakar sir is LCEH from Chandanben Homeopathic Medical College, Mumbai, MD, Doctor of Medicine in Homeopathy from Baba Saheb Ambedkar University, Marathwada. Friends, I'm literally shivering speaking these words about myself. Please bear with me. Dr. Praful Gajanan Vijayakar sir is a world-renowned homeopathic practicing classical homeopathy for over 40 years in Mumbai, Maharashtra. What sets Dr. Praful Vijayakar sir, my guru, apart from other homeopaths, is in his deep and exhaustive study in the science of homeopathy. He believed the fact that homeopathy is a modern method of treatment where the embryology and genetics can work in tandem, and he used for all diseases which are known and unknown to humans, thereby breaking the myth that homeopathy only works for cough and cold. Homeopathy, which was losing shine across the world, suddenly woke up to the new sunrise of the right homeopathy. Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir, through his lectures and seminars, enthralled the audience and made them confident of the noble and divine science of homeopathy. He revitalized the entire system, shook them up from their lethargy, and showed them how homeopathy combined with embryology and gentex is more potent than any other branch of medicine. He showed the world who dares wins. He is a great teacher who has inspired generations of homeopaths, cutting across boundaries drawn by humans, teaching the world the divine science of homeopathy. This can be easily seen when he had traveled to Russia and USA to conduct seminars, also in countries like Germany, Brazil, Switzerland, Austria, UK, France, Italy, on invitation. His classes and seminars have shown the path of right homeopathy to thousands of doctors worldwide. His reach does not stop at only homeopaths, scores of allopaths and doctors of other branches of medicine has and are the students of Praful Vijaykar sir. Till date, he trained around more than 25,000 doctors directly through seminars, and I am only one from them and other mediums. At AIH seminar, International Seminar, ECPD, European Center of Peace and Development, Dr. Praful Vijaykar's strong foundation in medicine, plus his untiring zeal, hard work, and dedication got a shot in the arm when European Center of Peace and Development, ECPD, an arm of United Nations, organized his tremendous work in the field of homeopathy, invited to ECPD headquarters in Belgrade to be conferred an honorary PhD. Predictive homeopathy became the only course of the entire homeopathy world to be accredited by ECPD, which only shows the advancement in the field of homeopathy brought by Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir. He will to dare and conquer homeopathy. His will to dare and conquer homeopathy got him the name Lion of Homeopathy. ECPD MOU was done with Professor Dr. Alexander Christie, co-director of ECPD. Signing ceremony, contributions of homeopathy and contributions to the homeopathy with this legend. Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir is not only a popular homeopath and gifted prescriber, his reputation as a scholar and a lecturer is impeccable. He manages to link theory and practice the classical homeopathy in the convincing and comprehensible way, and to combine the visionary with the achievable. Video cases and vivid presentations of Materia Medica serve as evidence for his profound knowledge. His seminars and talks are popular among homeopaths all over the world. Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir, practicing and teaching years are known as renaissance of homeopathy. The game-changing fact was that homeopathy is not an old science as believed by many, by modern science, which can keep pace with ages to come. His researches brought him to the fact that genetics and embryology can be merged with homeopathy, thereby bringing all the diseases known to man treatable and curable with homeopathy. He studied the old homeopathic principles laid down more than two centuries back. He upgraded them by explaining their correlation of embryology, genetics, modern science, giving evidence that homeopathy is totally scientific. He reviewed the Organon of Medicine and several books on homeopathy philosophy, which was ambiguous and not properly understood. He made the art of practicing homeopathy not just simple and comprehensible, but also guided regarding the applicability of those principles in a regular practice. He has also prepared scientific charts, namely the miasmatic chart of suppression and chart for theory of acutes for easy reference. Today, we doctors are very, 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 very absolutely free prescribing and medicine seeing Sir's theory of acutes chart. Otherwise, in previous practice, we would literally shiver to take an acute case. But today, with Sir's theory of acutes chart, helps us to take the acute cases confidently. The theory of acutes for an easy reference. The latter is also available in the form of mobile app with the name TOA, Theory of Acutes by Praful Vijaykar. His firm belief that homeopathic science is not just limited to cure of allergic and skin disorders, but is an optimum tool for treatment of chronic cases and irreversible pathologies. Dr. Samuel Hahnemann, the founder of homeopathy, instructed to treat man in disease and not the disease in man. As he believed in having the holistic approach towards the patient. But unfortunately, in all these years, many doctors gave their own speculative theories about it, which led to the downfall of homeopathy. But Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir has made successful in simplification and practical application of the work of Master Hahnemann, strictly following guidelines laid down by Dr. Hahnemann. He has thus contributed to standardization of homeopathic practice. German website dedicated to Praful Vijaykar sir is also seen. Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir, the bacon. The stinging fact that kept Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir up all night was that how to spread the new found knowledge to all those doctors worldwide who has not comprehended the exact nature as how homeopathy is relevant in the modern age when allopaths looked breathed down on homeopaths. Then it dawned on him and he took the same path as Dr. Samuel Hahnemann, his teacher, had taken to propagate homeopathy. He pooled all his knowledge he had on a paper. It went on day and night. He wanted it to be simple and easy to understand, but yet does not lose its vitality. His first work, Theory of Suppression, was introduced in 1996. In the first year of the launch, the book became runaway success. The doctors worldwide welcomed the book with hands wide open. He had cracked the first nut and he was ready with the next launch, next very year, Theory of Acutes, and went on writing 6 more books like Theory of Suppression, Theory of Acutes, The End of Action of Miasms, Homeopathy and Modern Medicine, Verbatim, Genetic Materia Medica, Treasures of Dr. Vijaykar, compiled by Dr. Gunter Luz, Theory of Suppression. Marathi translation is also available, friends, with frequent encounters. Praful Vijaykar sir's books are popular worldwide. He made sure the books are not used as a product of profit, but leaves of knowledge. Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir, the honor. He is the president of IIHP, that is Indian Institute of Homeopathic Practitioners, since 1991, and has been spreading his valuable teachings to all the homeopaths worldwide through continued medical education seminars conducted regularly under his guidance. Dr. Vijaykar sir uses the knowledge of the modern medical sciences, genetics, physiology, psychology, and biochemistry, and combines it with the knowledge of classical homeopathy. He has thrived to elucidate the progression of disease parallel to the development of the embryo in utero. By this new systematic approach towards the old principles, he thus predicted with certainty about the course of disease, that its prognosis after treatment. Yes, we are confident today to give the patient the prognosis after taking the classes given by my guru, Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir. Predictive homeopathy, which was launched in 1995. Sir says, sky's the limit for talented. And sir also says, he went beyond the so-called scope of homeopathy when he started giving miraculous results in cases of genetic mutation, which were normally termed incurable by allopathic fraternity. He also found a breakthrough for embryology. He gave new wings to homeopathy through his advanced research on embryology and how its benefits can advance medical sciences. Friends, his students have witnessed sight being restored to certified cases of blindness, mentally retarded behaving intelligently, and deaf responding to voice commands. To put it in Dr. Vijaykar sir's words, this is what the divine science of homeopathy is meant for the cure of so-called incurable cases and not merely cough and cold, coryza and skin allergies. Treatment of all such cases is Dr. Vijaykar sir's forte, and he has well documented them. Dr. Vijaykar sir has been an ex-homeopathic physician of Mumbai Devi Medical College and Hospital, Mumbai professor of European Center for Peace and Development, Belgrade, honorary professor at Sonaji Rao Shirsagar Homeopathic Medical College, Bid, other universities which have given recognition to predictive homeopathy are Maharashtra University of Health Sciences, American Institute of Homeopathy, along with New York Medical College, where his teachings are propagated on home.usa.org. Germany, which was the birthplace of homeopathy, has also embraced Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir's teachings and unique methods. Dr. Vijaykar sir and his team regularly conducted lectures in Regensburg School of Homeopathy. University of Thailand and the Ministry of Health, DPU, has given recognition to his courses. He has been giving lectures in different parts of the world and has inspired and encouraged more than 5 lakh students and practitioners all over the world and is continuing his efforts till date. In 2014, he has invited to Thailand for the lecture on his research on stem cells. He has his chain of clinics in more than 20 cities in India. Dr. Vijaykar sir has also started online training courses for doctors in distant lands with zero monetary benefits, with a vision of spreading correct homeopathy to every corner of the world. Dr. Vijaykar sir, along with his team, has spread homeopathy not only in India, but internationally, also by conducting regular seminars in USA, London, Germany, Dubai, Thailand, Sri Lanka, Brazil, etc., and many more to be added. Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir is no small thing to speak, doctors. He's such a tall personality with so many awards around him. Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir was awarded by Dr. Hanumanian Lifetime Achievement Award by the Government of Maharashtra 25th April 2012. He was conferred the honorary PhD by ECPD, United Nations. He was a research director of extramural research accredited by AYUSH, Government of India. Nominee to the panel of homeopathic consultant to the President of India, of whom we can be proud. He was the panel doctor to our President of India. Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir was the President of Indian Institute of Homeopathic Physicians, Mumbai. He was Director of Predictive Homeopathic Clinics, National and International. Honorary Professor and Head of Department, Organon Shirsagar Homeopathic College, Bid, Maharashtra. Dean, Specialty School of Predictive Homeopathy in collaboration with United Nations. University of ECPD. President of Indian Institute of Medical Homeopathy, IIHP. Ex-Professor of Honorary Physician at Chandavan Mona Mohan Bhai Patel Homeopathic Medical College, Mumbai. Ex-Honorary Professor of Homeopathy, Mumbadevi Medical College and Hospital, Irla, Mumbai. Maharashtra Council of Homeopathy gave tribute to Vijaykar sir's dedication and hard work, as we are also dedicatedly bowing before this sir, Om Vijaykaraya Namaha, by honoring him with the Lifetime Achievement Award. Dr. Vijaykar sir was awarded the Dhanavantri Award by Mangeshkar Hospital, Pune, for his contribution towards homeopathy and mankind. He has also been awarded with Lifetime Achievement Award by Lokma for his selfless homeopathic service in rural areas. Dr. Praful Vijaykar, the man with white feathers. Dr. Praful Vijaykar, sir, has a unique trait about him. He believes that effort yields its own rewards. He has mastered the art of going beyond the reality of diseases. He has successfully found a cure in many rare cases for which no other branch of medicine has ever found. This was possible only because of Dr. Vijaykar, sir, did not put his feet down at the obvious. He challenged himself, and his wisdom helped him look beyond medical science and his explanations. Dr. Praful Vijaykar, sir, is a master physician. He never says no to anyone or any disease. There are cases where the rarest of the rare cases have been cured by Dr. Praful Vijaykar, sir. He is an angel in disguise for thousands who had been to his clinic with a single hope of relief. There are cases where he had brought patients from out of coma with a single drop of dilution. He is up for any challenge thrown at him. As a doctor, he always believes in the patients first and used to sit in his clinic till late nights, caring for the patients, giving them hope and will. The patients swear by his medicines and his skills as doctors. Some of the rare diseases are listed below. The diseases are endless. The syndromes cleared by Sir, like Kiefer, Jenny atrophy, limb girdle muscular atrophy, FKTN related genetic mutation, Stroop-Weber syndrome, tuberculoma, hydrocephaly, epidermolysis bullosa, lateralis, Kimura's disease, osteoporitis, retinitis pigmentosa, adactylia, osteogenesis imperfecta, and hemangioma, Moya disease, and many, many, many doctors. Just to name the few from the exhaustive list of diseases. As nominee of the panel of homeopathic consultant to the President of India, he has been personal physician to presidents like Shri Pratibha Patil, Shri Ram Nath Kovind, etc., who have requested Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir's consultation multiple occasions. Dr. Vijaykar sir has been a frequent visitor to Rashtrapati Bhavan as an homeopathic advisor to Honorary President Shri Ram Nath Kovind ji and his family. With President of India Pratibha Patil, Shiv Sena Chief Bal Thackeray, eminent doctors, sports persons, bureaucrats, politicians have time and again implied about Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir's mastery over homeopathy. Hope for the hopeless camps is another golden feather cap in sir's thing. Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir is the people's man. He has always put people on their pain before him. After all that he achieved, he still wanted to do something worthwhile in the field of healthcare and that world that would benefit people from all walks of life. He saw children, financially backward families, unable to get any treatment, especially for those who diagnosed with genetic disorders. Nobody wanted to come forward for these children because of the belief that genetic disorders are incurable. He wanted to give children their right to be treated and relieved them of their pain. This gave birth to an idea, HRDF, that is Homeopathic Research and Development Foundation. HRBF in the year 2004, he has started, wherein he started conducting camps for, titled Hope for Hopeless in 2005 in Mahabaleshwar, Satara, for all physically challenged kids and genetic mutational disorders. In 2007, he started the Hope for Hopeless camp in Ghatkopar, Mumbai. These camps are conducted at regular intervals of 2 to 3 months to maintain. Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir has formed teams of doctors who give their services in these camps absolutely free of charge. The camp started in with 35 to 40 patients. Now you see 2,000 to 2,500 patients consulting the panel doctors, receiving medicines free of cost in each of their camps. Absolutely a god in the human. Mahabaleshwar camp, Ikhtapuri camp, Matunga camp, following all the states in which these camps are being conducted regularly. Maharashtra, Akola, Bid, Mahabaleshwar, Mumbai, Nagpur, Pune, Amravati, Nasik, Ghatpuri. Madhya Pradesh, Bilai, Gwalior, Neemaj, Indore, Bhopal, Shulajpur, Bilai. In Gujarat, Surat, Chhattisgarh, Orissa. In Kerala, it is Kochi, Thrissur, Calicut. Tamil Nadu, Sir conducts camps in Madurai. Uttar Pradesh, Varanasi and Lucknow. Delhi, Haryana, Panipat, Secunderabad in Telangana. Punjab, Firozpur, Ludhiana, Rajasthan, Jaipur. The massive wave of charitable clinics is not sponsored by any business tycoon or pattern, and yet is successfully going all over the India because of selfless services offered by Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir and his students. The success of these camps is because of the results and is not attributed to any sort of advertisement. Homeopathy, as he says, is based on immutable laws of science and nature. Hence, with his positive attitude and forceful drive, he moves on confidently on his chosen mission, that is propagation of right homeopathy. Friends, just give me one moment to complete saying about this great man. Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir, the man who never tires. If he is not in the clinic, he would be writing, researching, teaching. He never sits idle for him. He breathes and lives with homeopathy. He never forgets his teacher, Dr. Samuel Hahnemann. Make sure any seminar, class, or any occasion that Dr. Samuel Hahnemann gives his respect and takes his blessing. Dr. Hahnemann would be proud of such a brilliant and enigmatic doctor who not only professes but practices homeopathy in the true Hahnemannian letter and spirit. Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir rarely comes before the media. Though the media runs behind him, he interviews and bites. He never showed inkling towards it. But when he does, everyone sits up to notice. Corona lockdown. Even during Corona lockdown, ongoing pandemic, Dr. Sir Praful sir did not rest. Chose to get connected to homeopaths across the globe on multiple online seminars. Thousands of homeopathic practitioners and students joined to contemplate and formulate homeopathic support and treatment line in COVID under the chief guidance of Dr. Vijaykar sir. Dr. Vijaykar sir's online lectures also comprised complications arising post-COVID treatment. Friends, Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir has assorted feathers up his cap. This man has never surrendered to lost cause. He has been a ray of hope for all the hopeless patients. Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir has time and again proved his mettle in the fields of medical advancement and research and has never settled without coming victorious. He is often compared to Einstein for his developmental research, sound knowledge base, strong willpower, and firm resilience. Over the years, Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir has earned unwavering admiration, support, and veneration from all his peers, staff, and the masses. And yet, Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir is the same man, staunch vision and unquestionable ethics have helped him to grave a niche for himself in humanitarian field of work as well such as the HRDF camps. He is there from start to finish. Friends, many, many things can be added and said about this great personality. I'm fortunate I am in this decade as a student of Dr. Praful sir. Om Vijayakaraya Namaha. And I'm very happy to see you all joining me to say few words about sir. I stand here before you. Whenever I talk about Praful Vijayakar sir, I always say to all my friends, all the other colleagues, my fellow doctors, that mera maika hai, predictive mera maika hai. Agar main yahan Hyderabad mein hoon, mera papa ka maika, to Mumbai mera dusra maika hai. Because every small thing, if I had any doubt also, I would just stand straight to ask him and he would help me. Friends, today I'm very, I know everyone is sad about the demise of son. But I now welcome Dr. Amrish Bhaiya, Amrish Vijayakar. Yes, Dr. Amrish Bhaiya, are you there?
Can you hear me? Yeah, can you hear me?
Yeah. Yes.
Yes, I'm.
Namaste, Dr. Amrish.
Namaste.
I'm very sorry. We have all missed a great personality. Would you please say few words about our teacher?
Yes. First of all, we are really sad, and you know, this is a real calamity which has struck us. And it's not only the family, but the entire homeopathic fraternity and medical fraternity is shocked by my father passing away for his onward journey. It was really a fighting struggle, you can say, for last 25 days that he fought, we fought. Together we were fighting. And but, you know, destiny had some other plans, sir had some other plans, and we could not save him. But I'm sure, you know, it is said that legends, when they are never born, they never die. They just visit this planet and they go back. And this is exactly what I feel is it's sir who has chosen to live on that particular day. Because this is what exactly what I have learned from my father is, you know, the birth time and the death time is never ever in anybody's hand. It is decided by the divine power. And it is decided by the karmas which we do. And this is exactly what I saw, the mathematics which he has always said, that life is a mathematics. It's not only homeopathy, life is a mathematics. And exactly mathematically, if you see, the day he left was the day in Maharashtra we celebrate as a Margashish Mahina. You know, first day of Margashish Mahina. And in our, which we call as even the day of Khandoba, that means Shara Yatra. So it's the most auspicious day, the divine day for heavenly abode. It's really a calamity. We are really in shock. We don't know what has, we don't have words. The entire family, especially my mother, we all are just missing him every day in, day out. At every juncture, we remember him. And, you know, this moment, really, I can say that the amount of condolences, inspiration, support, love, respect coming and flocking from all over India and all across the globe is phenomenal, really phenomenal. And the amount of love and respect what sir has, they have for sir, I wish he was present here and I could show him that we all love him so much. The people of India, homeopaths, not only homeopaths, doctors, even the patients love you so much, because everybody has the same saying that it's a loss to human life and human fraternity and medical fraternity as well. I wish I could show him, because, you know, he would know and probably he would try to come back that so many people love him. I cannot imagine that how happy he must be. But I'm sure he's not left us. He's always with us. He will always stay with us with his energy and divine blessings, because I know my father, he's always looking and monitoring us, what we are doing, how we are doing, and how, you know, we are taking life. Because he is and he was a principled person. He was a person who always believed in high morals. Because for the world, he was a guru, he was a teacher. But for me, he was a father first. Me and my brother, both, he was a father first. So if I'm allowed to share a few memories of him, as we grew up, he always took us in, you know, any kind of discussion, because this is how we said that I want you all to take decisions. No matter you falter, you fail, you come out with some solution, I'm there with you. I'm there with you. You just go ahead, you take a decision. And this is the first the learnings what we learned from him was, take a decision, go ahead, no worries, mistakes do happen. And we always had him behind, saying that, if anything falters, I'm there with you. Then, very interestingly, what he used to always say is, it's all about what you do. It's not about how much money you earn. It's not about what you have, but it's all about what work you do. Because when you ultimately leave the world, it's your work which is going to remain. And this is exactly what I'm seeing now. And I can really relate his words and his saying that when you leave the world, it's the work of his which has remained behind. And the work is so divine and touched so many hearts and so many lives, whether it is homeopathic doctors or whether it is patients. It's touched them. It's touched their heart and their life. And this is what remains. The fragrance of his name in everybody's minds, which will go on for years and years to come. Nobody can really forget him. So that's the first part of the lessons which we learned from him. Because yes, we learned homeopathy, we were learning homeopathy, but it's a way of life for us. He is not only a teacher, but he's taught us the way of life, how life should be lived. And in every difficult situation, in every pessimistic condition, he would always see a positive. He always see that dot and the energy of positivity. This is what I saw, and this is what made him really curious and go about in his professional practice. Also, I spoke to a few editors which called me as they were also shocked, said that, your father never gave up. And, in one of the media, he was called as the Yamdutacha Kattar Dushman, which means, the enemy of Yamdut, basically. And he said he just smiled at the editor and said, okay, it's a sweet name. But then that editor said, sir, this is the app name, because you have always fought and you've always stood in between humans and their disease, and hence you will always be a dushman for the Yamdut, which is a very apt name, which we saw in years how he fought difficult diseases and how he could get back people to life. Of course, then you know, we have beautiful memories as whenever we traveled out. He was a very, very fun-loving and jolly person. He loved traveling. He loved cricket. He loved movies, you know. He loved, you know, especially in recent times when there was a new movie, he was the first one to take buy a ticket, go and sit and watch a movie cinema. Because he said, you never know from where you learn. And this is was his, the next lesson was, keep learning, keep learning, keep learning. You never know. It's not only homeopathy, but from where you can learn, you never know. Even a smallest of, you know, situation in your life can also teach you. So keep learning and keep going ahead. And that was the second lesson, what we learned from him. Of course, there are many things. I would not try to go into details of it, but yes, what he has given us, we will all never forget. He's given us the education, the knowledge, the teachings which he has given us will never, never go waste. They will always stay in our hearts. And you see, you know, the generations of doctors, the seniors who are already practicing for so many years, they have gained from his vast experience. And the generations who are coming from behind, I'm sure they will take the essence of this beautiful knowledge and the foundation which he has given and put, practice in the right sense and with conviction, and see the difference happening in their practice. Of course, there are many, many, many other things, but you know, these are the few attributes which I wanted to share, because you know, people ask us that, you know, a lot of WhatsApp coming up to me, and what is the illness? What really happened to him? You know, what went wrong? And then I personally felt that rather than discussing what happened to him, he's a human. We can't forget he's a man. He has to follow the laws of nature. He has to follow the law, the nature principles. So he will get sick. He will have issues. So rather than discussing what went wrong and what he suffered from, I think, this is my personal opinion, we should discuss the glory of the past, how his glorious, you know, life and the contribution to homeopathy and the medical fraternity should be discussed, because that is what is going to give energy to his soul, and his soul can rest in peace. Thank you, Dr. Gayatri Devi, and the entire team of Predictive Studies Circle for having this condolence meeting. I wish that this was not a condolence meeting and this was a lecture session. But unfortunately, you know, it is in true. One more thing which I would want to, you know, emphasize here on was, sir always said that, you know, spread this knowledge. Take Amrish, you try to take this knowledge to people. Don't try to sell this knowledge. You know, make sure that this knowledge reaches each and every individual, because we want to focus on the roots. We want to focus on the roots. So when it is about the disease, it is also on the roots. Whether it is about the education, it is also on the students. And this is exactly from where his journey started. He started focusing much on the students primarily, and then and when it grew, it went to the practitioners. So, you know, in the recent time, just before he fell sick, we had a beautiful discussion, and which, you know, I could gather an outline of his journey, of his educational, you know, educational journey. Was the initial part of his teaching was always on the scientific base. Rather, you know, he focused on science, focused homeopathy is a science, because he wanted people to come towards homeopathy, and so that they practice homeopathy. He showed them that single dose can do miracles. It showed them that, you know, you can achieve results. It showed that that homeopathy has a power, but you need to prove that in terms of science. So where he, you know, taught all the myasms, the journey of disease, you know, the biochemistry, the physiology, he emphasized and correlated homeopathic principles with modern medicine. and bridged them and show them that how homeopathy was scientific. But as and when I discussed still further with him, then he said that when you start practicing homeopathy on these lines, and when you evolve as an individual and you evolve as a practitioner, a time will come, a day will come, you will understand the divinity in homeopathy. And in the initial phase, we really didn't understand that what is the word divinity, why my father is saying how homeopathy can be divine, it's just a material science. But then as and when we started practicing those on those lines, he had experience and he wanted all the doctors and students to experience, we started experiencing the actual divine power. So first he emphasized on the scientificness of homeopathy, and the second part he emphasized that homeopathy is a divine science and it works wonders. It's not only on the physical phenomena of the body, but the entire aura of that particular individual. And this is exactly where he, you know, in Marathi we say that it is first the Vijnan and then it is the Adhyatma. So first it is a science and then it is a spirituality. The spirituality doesn't exist because of science. The science exists because of spirituality. And this was exactly what he wanted to mean. And he said, Amrish, that they people, because people, not many homeopaths and doctors are only practicing homeopathy as a science, but the day people understand the divinity and the spirituality in homeopathy, I think they have understood homeopathy truly, and I'm sure they will practice correctly and rightly. So, you know, on this condolence meeting, I would try to assure you, and we would like to take a vow that whatever teachings he has left behind, you know, try to carry teaching forward, continue this teaching, and make sure that we reach maximum doctors, maximum homeopaths, and they can be benefited, mankind can be benefited, and we will try to, I don't know, but I will try my best. I hope I can do justice to his teachings, which he has laid for mankind. And thank you very much for having this meeting. And let us pray to the Almighty that he will stay with us forever, he will bless us forever, he's watching us, and so that we can do his job, Hanuman's job, and keep continuing this this education in much more honest, dedicated and committed manner. Thank you so much, and I pray his soul rest in peace. Thank you.
I really thank you for being with us, Dr. Amrish Bhaiya. Yeah, I'm really blessed to be connected to the predictive homeopathic system of medicine, where I should not forget the people who have introduced me to the predictive, because after resigning my job as a medical officer, I had great time, and that's how I have converted myself to full practice of predictive only. And for this, I should really remember and thank the predictive members of Hyderabad, the predictive founder members who have initiated my thought process too. Amrish Bhaiya, it is none other but Dr. Satyanarayana Butada sir, Dr. Srikant Morlo sir, Dr. Manu Srikant Manu ji, Dr. Murlidhar ji, and many more, Dr. Vashish sir, Dr. Asif sir, they were all behind. And I'm very, very fortunate to be. They are guiding me time and again to do every activity of predictive in city of Hyderabad. I now invite Dr. Satyanarayana Butada sir to say a few words about this meeting and everything. Sir, please.
Good evening to all. This is the moment we remember our sir, what he has given to us throughout the life. His teaching, I remember very well in 1998 when he attended the first seminar in Hyderabad, and we're very much new to this science, what is a predictive. And then afterwards with continuous interrogations, seeing the results, we have started here as 2002, our study group. That day and today, till we are in the selfless service to the humanity, And so many doctors are getting benefited with our Thursday teaching, sharing our knowledge and spreading this right homeopathy throughout the state. I am very much thankful to all my team members, those who have taken the responsibilities and spreading this right science to the world. So many my colleagues are there. They want to pay the tribute to this legend. I don't take much more time to say so many things to that, but I am very much assured from Dr. Amrish, whatever sir has given is to be continued for the human being, mankind, and the service. Om Vijay Karayana. Thanks. Dr.
Sir, I now request Dr. Sampath sir to please speak few words about us, sir, because Sampath sir has helped me a lot, helped us a lot indeed in every predictive seminar. Sampath sir.
Good evening, Dr. Gayatri, and hello to my predictive friends. I deeply hurt and sad listening the news of Dr. Vijaykar was no more. He is the person who has taken the homeopathic science, so which was left long back by Dr. Hahnemann and his contemporaries like Dr. Boningasan and Dr. Kent and all. So after that, there was a very long gap. So this long gap could able to be filled by Dr. Vijaykar. So Vijaykar sir has given lot many things to the homeopathic doctors to take it to the next level after Hahnemann. So my association with Dr. Vijaykar sir goes back to 1986, where in that year I organized a journal IHP conference in Gulbarga. Later I invited him to Gulbarga in 2005, and my college was always open for the predictive seminars, and I was in constant touch with sir during these years. So as the predictive family members, our earnest duty would be so taking this beautiful science where the sir left to the further level, that would be the tribute that we can pay as the predictive family members. So with this few words, Dr. Amrish, so yes, we are with you in the journey of taking this predictive homeopathy to the further level. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.
Yes, Dr. Amrish Bhai, even I take an opportunity to promise and say that we are going to take the torch of practicing the right homeopathy further as taught by our guru and father, Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir. Now, I request Dr. Vashish sir to say a few words. Dr. Vashish sir.
Namaskar, friends. It has been a great loss to our homeopathic fraternity. In fact, Dr. Vijaykar was first time introduced to me by Dr. Narendra Mehta. And the very thought when we just, Narendra Mehta talked to us about what he had been doing in Bombay, and they were having meetings in Lonawala every Thursday. That was our starting point. That earlier to that, we always used to meet once in a month. we used to have some seminars, but that particular thought of Dr. Vijaykar made us to see that we meet every week and talk only about our subjects. So that led to our meetings on Thursdays. And friends, as it is, I feel, or it's not feeling, it's a truth that Dr. Vijaykar was a divine gift to our homeopathic fraternity. He was sent by God to us to enlighten the organon of medicine, see, which we probably at that stage, we were using it or only reading it only for our exams. He was a person who has brought that light from the organon and showed us the way the homeopath should practice homeopathy and gave us that feeling that yes, a single remedy, a single dose can cure a patient. So that was a gift he has given us. And I still remember that I understood miasm only while going through his preface of the book of miasms. Earlier to that, even after my 10, 15 years of my practice, I was not able to understand miasm, but that book, when I read it, only when I read the preface, I was able to understand it and then found the importance of miasms in the practice. Then his book on suppression was really an enlightenment for us, for as far as the hearing law of cure was concerned. His research work, what he has done for us, the disease descent chart, the seven layers of suppression, friends, it will be guiding us for years to come. I personally feel the true gift, a true tribute to Dr. Vijaykar should be that probably today we are almost 100 doctors who are sitting here or hearing him. We should make it a point that his books, they reach the final year students of all the homeopathic medical colleges of India. We should make it a point that his knowledge, his work does not go in vain. We should make it a point that the teachings of Dr. Vijaykar should reach each and every homeopathic college, especially the final year students. Thanks a lot. Thank you.
It is very true, the words what you have told. We will all start practicing the same. Now, I request Dr. Muralidhar ji to please speak few words about our beloved sir. Muralidhar ji.
Hi friends, just returned from the funeral, seeing sir in that state is something which we have not anticipated so early. The day before, to decide whether I should go or not, because age, people are telling, don't go. I said, I cannot remain in Hyderabad and relax, calling myself as a franchisee holder in Secunderabad, as well as student of sir. So I had gone there, I've seen practically. So if you see his face, you must see that energy of his face, you know, can tell you that he is a divine soul, and we walked along the path to the cremation as though we are just given the direction to walk in that way. All of us silently walk towards the cremation to offer our gratitude. Means when a guru passes away, we should not cry. Krishna says, don't have shokha when a great person dies. Learn from him. We take the name, we have to learn from him. Learning is doing what you have learned. Learning is not just learning, doing is knowing. So are we doing? We need to do. If you do, you know what is actual teachings of sir. Last month when he spoke to me about half an hour, he was discussing on the various aspects of the divineness of homeopathy. And you know, I was very much fortunate to listen to him for about half an hour. Friends, I always say one thing. To be a predictive homeopath, you have to enroll yourself. Enrolling means you have to be part of it. We are associated, we are learning books through books, but we are not enrolling ourselves because still there are certain doubts or certain things which we are not able to unfold. So what I see personally is he is not gone, only mortal body is not there. He is there with us in the form of thought, deeds, and actions, in deeds. Now we have to take that into that books or the material which he has given to the world day by day. And you see that sir is all around us. When I opened the Secunderabad branch of franchisee, sir said, now I don't have to think that I should able to treat patients there. My hand is there. He used to always say, my hand is there. So we are all his hands. So we are all his hands. Let us really take the responsibility. Now he has left the world to give a message to us that all of you are depending on me. I'm only a big tree. A small tree will not come under a big tree. He had to sacrifice his life so that we become a tree and give support to others, shelter to others. And that is the reason why he had taken a step like this. May God give him a lot of satisfaction of this contribution to this entire suffering humanity. And we following sir is ultimately, we are also blessed indirectly seeing that we are following the right method. People who have been talking about sir's approach, I only say only one thing honestly. Hahnemann was not understood because we could not understand the science. Sir understood Hahnemann, so it is easy to understand Hahnemann through sir. So if you follow sir, you are following Hahnemann. May God bless you.
Thank you very much, Mullidhar Garu. Yeah, we need to spread the tree. We need to give shade to the younger generation because we have learned a bit of the homeopathy. The homeopathy is a vast subject. It's an ocean. Which sir would always say, it's an ocean. It's infinite. We know a bit of it. And definitely, I promise again to share that little bit of knowledge with other my fellow practitioners of predictive practitioners. Now, I request Dr. C.J. Varghese to say few words. Dr. Sri J. Varghese. And before I say, one second.
Am I audible?
One minute.
Am I audible?
This is going live on the YouTube. If someone is still waiting in the waiting room, please connect yourself to the YouTube link which is being circulated. The session is going around YouTube. Already many people have joined on YouTube. Yeah, Dr. Varghese, please continue.
Thank you, Dr. Gayatri Devi, Dr. Amrish, Dr. Puttada, Congress Sambasar, Dr. Murlithar, and all my beloved friends there in Hyderabad. I need not repeat that it's the most saddening incident in our lifetime. Any amount of time I can talk about him, bringing to your attention the old good memories with him. It's a long time cherished memories. He was a friend of mine. I'm proud of that. And I'm proud of being given the opportunity to live in his lifetime. I was led into the right homeopathy, my asam-based right homeopathy, through him only. He was my guru. And it was from him only I got to understand what exactly is the real miasm. I learned Metriamudika from him. And I was fortunate to be a friend of him. He was my guide. He was my philosopher. He was my teacher. He was the family doctor of my family. I don't have much words when the heart is full. Words are few. And I'm not going to take much of your valuable time. I'm really honored to be given a chance to speak on this occasion. It's a really painful and relating. We will carry forward this divine science to the greater heights as per his wish and directions. As per our faith, his soul is around us, seeing us, listening to us. Therefore, thank you, sir. Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.
Bye. Yeah. It is very true. Wherever sir is, he will be watching us constantly and guiding us, because it's a divine science. And I have the sir's face was also so divine when he was on the funeral berth also. Now, I request Dr. N. Srinivas Rao Garu to please speak words about our beloved sir.
Good evening, friends. It's really a very, very sad and unfortunate occasion that we are having to meet like this. But definitely a legendary figure and a great soul that has moved across the threshold to be in the heavenly abode, where he's really, I'm sure, happy to watch all over us. And I'm certain that, you know, though he's physically not with us, he lives amongst us in our hearts through his teachings and through his inspirations and everything that we have learned to enjoy about the authentic homeopathy. He's been a colossal inspiration to most of us, and he's really put India on a global homeopathic map. He's taken us to great, great heights. It's really a very, very sad situation for us. And we certainly have a great responsibility to uphold homeopathy and the values that he taught us, and the whole moral ethics that he has given to us as homeopaths to live up the reputation of homeopathy. I'm once again, I sincerely pray for his soul, and we will continue to hold him very close to our hearts and carry the torch that he's lit amongst us to greater heights. Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity, Predictive Group. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Yes. Now I request Dr. Ramdas to please speak few words about our guru. Dr. Ramdas Garu.
I cannot say anything.
Please hold your courage as we are doing, because we need to take the torch which sir has lit and left it. Ramdas Garu.
Amrish. No, I cannot speak anything. I don't want to see this also. I cannot see this. I cannot see this. My sir is a lion. In my views, sir is there in that chair. Sir is there with that suit. Sir is coming down with BMW, Audi, and he is teaching us lessons. And I want to remember him like that only. And I want to have the I have the responsibility now to share his knowledge. Amrish, God is, and he is in need of our sir's help now. Thank you. I cannot speak anymore. Thank you all.
Yeah. Now I request Dr. Sharvari Gandhi. Sharvari Gandhi, you wanted to speak. Are you there? Okay. Yes. Is anyone there to speak? Sharvari Gandhi, I am seeing a message that you want to say a few words about us, sir. Yeah. Now I request Dr. Chandrasekhar, who is helping and supporting me to take our predictive classes forward. I request Dr. Chandrasekhar to speak few words about our sir. I know it is hard to digest that sir is no more with us, but please take courage to speak. Yes.
Good evening, friends. And I am just heartbroken after hearing the sudden demise of the line of homeopathy and my mentor, Dr. Praful Vijaykar, sir. He always made homeopathy brighter and greater with his knowledge and wisdom. He made homeopathy 360 degrees, and all homeopaths are now all-rounders. They became all-rounders in treating emergency cases, acute cases, subacute cases, and chronic cases. And because of him, I think in the year 2013 or 2003 or 2004, we came together and we formed a platform. So we are improving our knowledge since then. So a platform was formed because of him. And with his with my close association with him, because he is a great you can say spiritual person, and he likes Lord Balaji. And my close association with him shows that he's an all-rounder. He has got tremendous knowledge, not only in homeopathy, but in all levels. I think he's a good, you can say, vastu, and he is a palmistry person. So lot of qualities. Okay, so I always remember him because he motivated, his teachings motivated me. Because of him, we are all together and we are improving our knowledge. And he always, I remember his famous dialogues. One is treating man in disease, not disease in man. And what your eyes cannot see, your mind does not perceive. Homeopathy is easy. Homeopathy is mathematics. Sir, you are there forever with us in our hearts and brain, and you are always motivating us. You always stand with us in treating difficulty and pathological cases. So my deepest condolences to his family members and homeopathic fraternity, and Dr. Ambarish also. With this, I take leave. Thank you for giving me this opportunity.
Yeah, definitely, sir would say that understanding patient is very important. Now I request Dr. Shantaprabhu, sir, to speak few words about our great guru. Dr. Amrish Bhaiya, they are all my pillars who support me to take the predictive forward. Dr. Shantaprabhu, sir, please.
Hello.
Yes, Dr. Shanti Prabhu, sir. Your video is not visible.
Just a minute. You start in another.
Okay.
Video will change. Hello.
Listen.
Hello.
Namaskaram, sir.
Namaste. Are you able to hear me? Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. I'm really very shocked to hear of the sudden demise of our Dr. Prabhu Vijaykar, sir. A great man appeared on this world, the world without announcing. And as long as he was here on this earth, he was a treasure to us. I don't know exactly what happened and what his last days were like and what exactly led to his demise. I was very fortunate to be associated with him and very close to him also, both professionally and at the personal level also. I was fortunate enough to see him practice in Mumbai, spent a few days with him.
Shanti Prabhu, sir.
Are you able to hear me?
Sorry to interrupt. You just set your phone, the video, and your mic is not nearer to you. You're not audible, sir.
Just a minute. వీడియో రావడం లేదు ఆరో
వస్తుందండి
వస్తుంది
వస్తుంది
ఆర్ ఏబుల్ టు హియర్ మీ యా ఐ యామ్ ఆడిబుల్
yes sir yes sir
shall I start now okay
yes
I am,
sir
I am really very shocked to hear of the sudden demise of our beloved Dr. Prafull Vijaykar sir I don't know what his last days were like and what exactly led his demise but it is very unfortunate very sudden great people they appear on the earth once their mission is finished they just suddenly leave this earth perhaps it was the divine will that he has accomplished his mission on earth and he had been called for his heavenly journey. And I was very fortunate to be associated with him and I was very close to him. I had spent a few days with him in his clinic at Mumbai. And it was a pleasure seeing him. More than, he was a great physician and he was a great teacher, but more than that, he was a great human being. He was very loving and very lovable also. He was very caring. He had a very radiant smile and a very calm demeanor and a manner in which he conducted himself. It made you feel at ease. When I met him, I could not see the lingering ego, which is so evident in many cases. He was so pleasant to talk with and so easy to get along with. Such a great man that it's very unfortunate. I feel personally very heartbroken that we'll be missing him forever. But alas, and when I saw some of as a physician, I was really awestruck to see some of his cures. I had seen some of the cases in which larynx had suddenly started stringing up, which was absent started stringing up. Retina, it had almost been destroyed completely, or certified as incurable blindness. They were getting back to sight, and retina started growing again, and they started degenerating again. When I saw him at work, I thought, this is one man, perhaps, who has reached such a pinnacle of skill and efficiency in homeopathy that he can even challenge death. I thought nobody can be in with India, but if there is someone who I thought could challenge death, this is one man. But alas, when death challenged him, he felt helpless. And that is what happens in many cases. And perhaps we feel that it is too early for him to leave, but perhaps God felt in a different way, a greater life awaits him in the other world or in the next life, as the belief may be. Definitely what he has accomplished here is difficult to describe because beyond all what words can describe. He was a great teacher in the sense that he made it very comfortable, not only imparting knowledge, but he was showing you how to acquire the correct path of knowledge. He not only gave you fish to eat, but he taught you the art of fishing. And all of his students should be grateful, because this is what really matters. You should try to develop on what he has taught you and reach and further develop your skills so that you can be a better physician. And he had varied interests. His life he was very much interested in astrology. He used to correlate astrology and homeopathy. I was not very inclined because I did not have much knowledge about this, but when I saw him doing that, I was really amazed and amused also to some extent, because he was correlating homeopathic with astrology and trying to base some of his predictions on that, or some of his prescriptions on the planetary positions. And he did succeed in some of these cases. He and Dr. Abhay Patel was very close to him in this respect. They used to do a lot of work in this respect. Similarly, his interest in spirituality. He personally told me a few things, and I also heard some of his lectures. He had a great spiritual leading, and he believed in the spirit, and he knew the greatness of the spirit, and he knew that man is born with something to be done in this earth, and that he had to accomplish. When doing all this, he never lost his scientific footing. That was very important. And then I saw him at work. One thing that struck me is his great amount of clinical knowledge and acumen and efficiency. His ability to diagnose at a very rapidly. I was the head of the Department of Medicine for almost 2 decades, and I knew how important diagnosis could be in the art of homeopathic practice and how it facilitates the practice. But when I saw him, it really being worked out. He was able to diagnose and he was able to correlate things. He had a wonderful depth of knowledge and he was very good at analysis. He used to analyze each and everything, but he never suffered from what is known as analysis paralysis. What ails many of us, I would say, many of us, what ails is we also try to analyze. We analyze a lot, go on analyzing and analyzing and analyzing. But ultimately, when it comes to helping people to prescribe properly, we feel paralyzed at times. But he was not afflicted with this. He used to analyze and then arrive at a position where he was able to prescribe properly and help the patients. And that was what was most important. It was his ability to help people, even in desperate situations. Perhaps there are many other people waiting to speak, and they cannot take much of the time. We feel that he has been called for suddenly, and that perhaps he could have lived a little more longer. It would have been a blessing on this earth. But what God wills, that it always happens. And I am sure, whatever may be, if it is the afterlife, he can rest because of the wonderful work he has done. Perhaps God will reward him with a very wonderful afterlife. If there is a next life, he will be born as a very noble being. Because it is said that Sri Aurobindo was once, in one of his earlier life, it is said he was part of forensic medicine. And in one of the subsequent lives, ultimately, he was born as Sri Aurobindo and achieved so much of spiritual glory and spiritual realization. So what he has been called for, perhaps that would be a greater meaning which we just cannot answer. What we can all do is follow his precepts correctly, how we have practiced, we should pay attention to be scientific and not led away by primary practices. We try to be as grounded as possible, as Dr. Vijaykar has taught us. And we should try to reach to the depths of homeopathy, try to carry it forward, because in homeopathy we can achieve. We have to ponder, we have to introspect, and we have to work very hard on these lines and try to develop homeopathy to some extent if we can contribute it. And I'm very sorry about his family. I think they'll be very grieved about his sudden demise. And I wish to offer my heartfelt condolences. We are all there with you in this painful hour, as I know it is the most painful hour for the family members. And I hope God gives courage and strength to his family members to face this very painful ordeal of his suddenly leaving us. And I hope God will be with all of us. And I hope that Dr. Vijayaka spirit will always live with us and inspire us to greater and greater things. With these few words, I'd like to close this call. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. It is really a blessing to earth and especially the homeopaths to learn, because the work which was done by Hahnemann couldn't be understood by many. Sir has made it very simple for us to understand. He is in disguise of Hahnemann only. It's not that we have lost him, but here from today, we pledge to be more stronger to practice the right homeopathy. Now, I really, really thank from my bottom of the heart for Dr. Amrish Bhai for joining the session. Friends, if anyone, the session is open for another 5 minutes. If anyone is willing to speak few words about this, sir, please don't take more time. You can please talk, unmute yourself and talk in very short. The session is open to the participants. If anyone is willing to talk, because with inhibitions, with the sadness, there are people I understand we can't express. If you want to express.
Ma'am, can I talk, ma'am?
Yeah, please.
My heartfelt condolences to the sir's family and all our predictive members. But one thing I can say is today I'm able to practice only because of this predictive teachings, what I learned from sir. One thing I miss is I wish I could see sir personally. I could not see him in person. But he is always in our hearts.
Doctor, any interference? It's been interrupted.
Dr. Gayatri, can I have a moment to speak, please? Venugopal here.
Yes, please do. Please continue, Dr. Venugopal Gowri.
Namaste to Dr. Gayatri and the predictive team here. Really, it's a very unfortunate moment for all the fraternity that we have lost a great gentleman who was a crusader for the cause of homeopathy. And on behalf of Homeopathic Medical Association of Telangana, I would like to convey our heartfelt condolences to the family of Dr. Praful Vijaykarji. Dr. Amrish, who is here, and from his words, we understand that how Dr. Vijaykar sir was not a man of money or any motto, but he lived for a cause of lived for work as worship, and I'm sure it is a lesson for all the generation of homeopaths who he has been able to influence. Because in contemporary homeopathy, we have seldom come across a person who could hold attention of more than 1,000 homeopaths in a gathering at one point of time. And we have seen that generation of homeopaths whom he held sway over. And as we understand from the memoirs of the great people like Dr. Shankaran, we understand that Dr. Vijaykar was always in touch with the contemporary homeopaths, the stalwarts of homeopathy, and they were always in sync, and they would never come with their thoughts of homeopathy, their different types of methods of practice of homeopathy would never come in their way, and they were all together. And I think we have a great lesson to learn from the virtue of his, and I'm sure it will be to come his life that he has lived, and we have seen it happening in front of us. And I thank Predictive School of Homeopathy Hyderabad, Dr. Gayatri Devi, seniors Dr. Bhutada ji, Dr. Vashish ji, Dr. Shantapati, for giving me an opportunity to speak on HMP behalf. Thanks and regards.
It is one family always, and it is Predictive Family, Dr. Venugopal. Yes, it's nice hearing from you. Now we'll be ending the closing. We are at the closure of this session.
Thank you. The world is immeasurably better because of you, sir. You have done the work. Now others will continue on the path you created. Your compassion, your love, your kindness, your intelligence inspired me as well as the millions. Thank you, sir. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.
Okay, no,